So you've purchased a YubiKey, maybe even a second one for backup. And if you're like most people, you immediately went and locked down your email account, which is awesome. But what else is there? I get this question a lot. So today you're gonna learn how to use your YubiKeys to lock down four of the most common apps and services that you might be using. So let's start with something as simple as Vanguard. If you are in your Vanguard account, you can click on login, and you're going to obviously use your username and login to log into your personal investor account or whatever account that you have with Vanguard. It's going to look almost exactly the same on whichever site that they have. You might have a security question set up. This is a second form of authentication, but not nearly as secure as using something like a security key. So once we are logged into our Vanguard dashboard, you're gonna go up to that right, you're gonna see that little icon near log off, and you're gonna click onto that. That is your profile and account settings. And if you scroll down, actually first we're gonna click on security and then scroll down, you're gonna find security key. This is where you're gonna be setting up a security key. But if you've never done this before, you're gonna need to make sure that you have set up these security codes. And I haven't done this before, so I'm going through, it's telling me all about setting up two-factor authentication, and I have to accept and continue with the terms of use. And the way that they're going to give me these codes is through my phone number. So I'm gonna go ahead and give them my phone number, which is not ideal, but this is the way that they require me to do it. Now they want me to add a second phone number, which I definitely don't wanna be doing, or add something like that. So I'm gonna go back to my account, and then I have to go through this whole process again. Go up to the icon in the upper right, go into security, and then scroll down to find security key. All right, it's gonna tell you that you're gonna need a FIDO2 compatible security key. Anything that you get from YubiKey is gonna be FIDO2 compatible. And then we're gonna have to scroll all the way down to the bottom, and then click I agree. If you don't scroll to the bottom, they won't let you click I agree, or they won't let you get through to the next screen, whatever. So at this point, they're gonna make me check my phone again. This is just for their own security's sake, I'm sure. It's a little annoying to me, but you're gonna be getting another code to your phone that you're gonna enter in here in order to verify that you are in fact the person who should be getting access and adding keys to this account, because obviously they don't want just anybody being able to add this. So you're gonna name your key. I have two keys. I've got the 5NFC and then I've got the 5CI. So I'm gonna go ahead and just do the 5 NFC here. And once I've named it, I'll click continue. If you have a password manager that wants to try to save a passkey, don't do that. Or if you get this kind of QR code, just plug the key in and press the button. Great, we've got one security key. And then of course you do want to add that second security key, and you're gonna go through this whole process again, where it's gonna tell you about the key that you're gonna be putting in. You've got to agree, scroll all the way to the bottom, and then register the key. And then you want to name it. As again, since I'm gonna be using this 5CI, I'm gonna do my YubiKey 5CI, click continue. I don't wanna save it in my password manager, and then I just plug it in, press the buttons, click allow if I have to, and wait for a moment while it registers. Excellent. We now have both of our security keys, the primary and the backup, set up on your Vanguard account. So this is what it would look like. If we were to go ahead and just log off of the Vanguard account, this is how the whole sign-in process would look now. If you remember last time we had to sign in with our username and password and then answer this random security question, this time when we sign in with our username and password, we're going to be requested to plug in our security key. And so I just plug it in, I insert the key, and I tap, and then I can log into my Vanguard account. Next, let's move on to your Apple iCloud account. If you use an iPhone, or even if you're using a MacBook, either one or both, you can set up a security key to lock down your accounts. So first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna open up our settings on our account, and you're gonna go and click on your name at the top up there. And when you click on that, you're gonna see sign in and security. This is where you're gonna do if you were to change your password, or if you were to add an account recovery, any of that, but we wanna click on two-factor authentication. You will probably already have a phone number added there. And now we wanna go into security keys and click set up. And you're gonna have to probably put in your password in order to do this, but beforehand, Apple lets you know that this, you need a FIDO certified key. Again, That is what a YubiKey is. So, and it's Apple also requires that you have two security keys, a primary and a backup, before you could even do any of this. So once you put in your password and you have your two keys ready, go ahead and click allow, and then it's going to walk you through. We're going to add the first key, click continue. And then I'm going to go ahead and put that key in and tap it, so that it is recognized by Apple. And once I do that, it will be added and it will go ahead and name that key. It's the YubiKey 5 series with NFC, and I click continue. And then I'm gonna add that second key. And this is where I'm gonna do my 5CI. So I'll click continue. It will prompt me to insert and activate, which I'm gonna do and touch. And now it has the name YubiKey 5CI, and I'll continue there. At this point, it wants me to review all of my active devices. I can take and remove some of these devices that force them to go through the sign-in process again, or I don't have to do that, which I don't want to. What's cool is that with this, and this is the same with Vanguard that we just did before, you can add more than two keys if you want. So if I want to have my wife's key also open up my Apple iCloud account, or if I have more than two YubiKeys, I can add all of those to my account, and each one of them will work. Now, the more you add, obviously, the more of a risk that you're taking, but it is nice that you can have more than just one backup on there. And then, of course, if you wanted to, for some reason, you could remove all keys right there. So now that I'm done with that, I can exit out of two-factor authentication and make sure that everything else in my iCloud account is locked down. All right, when it comes to Facebook, even if you are not an active user of Facebook, if you have a Facebook account, I recommend that you add a 2FA security key. Your YubiKey should lock down that account, because your Facebook account, even if you're not active on it, can be used against you. And it's really not that hard. So let's go ahead and open up our Facebook account. And if you go to the upper right on the icon here, we're going to look for settings and privacy, and then click on settings. And we're actually going to be looking at the meta password and security, because Facebook does it on just like a meta level. And now you have the option to look at both Instagram and Facebook accounts. So I'm going to click on password and security here. You see we have two-factor authentication. And then I'm going to get an option to choose which account. We're going to start with Facebook, and I'll explain why we can't really do it with Instagram. But you have different methods, and I'm going to go ahead and click on security keys because I have Facebook Protect, which is a advanced security program that I've talked about in the past. I've already had to have a security key on here, but I'm going to go ahead and register a new key. I'm going to go ahead and make sure that I don't save it in my 1Password. I'm going to plug in the key and press the button in order to register that account or that key, and I'm done with that. And I can, again, just like all these other accounts, I can add another one. Unfortunately, Facebook makes me go back and click through two-factor authentication, click on my account, Josh Summers here on Facebook, and then add another security key, but I can do that. I would recommend, by the way, I didn't do this, you see I don't do this here, but I would definitely recommend naming the keys so you know which one. So at the end here, as I finish doing all of these keys, you're gonna notice that it's just Josh's, 2FA security key is all that it names it, and that now I don't know which is which, or Josh's security key. You can rename those keys if you wanted to, and I recommend you do that. And then you want to look at additional methods. I use recovery codes. I prefer this over something. Authenticator app wouldn't be bad. Text message SMS would be something I would recommend against, so try not to do that. My two are security key and the recovery codes. And now you've locked down your Facebook account. We're almost done, and now we're gonna be looking at 1Password. 1Password is probably the most popular password manager on the market. It's the one that I use and recommend among a few others that I do like, but this is the one that I've chosen and that I use. If you use another password manager, chances are they also allow for 2FA security with a security key, and it might look similar, but I'm gonna go ahead and just walk you through 1Password. The thing about 1Password, and I think this applies to most of them, is if I go into my settings on the app on my device and I go into security, there's not much that I can do in terms of changing a password or adding 2FA. The most that I've got is just Touch ID to unlock, and I can change that, or auto lock. If you want to change anything having to do with your account password or 2FA, you need to log in to the web app. So I'm going to go into 1Password. I'm going to enter in, log in, use my password to sign in to my account here. And once I sign in, you can see here, it's just going to take a moment. You've got access to all your vaults. I'm going to go over here to the upper right on my name and click on My Profile. Now, there's a lot of information here, including an emergency kit that I would recommend, but click on More Actions, and then you're going to see Manage Two-Factor Authentication. And this is where you can set up an Authenticator app or, in our case, a security key. So go ahead and name that key. I'm going to start with the YubiKey 5CI here. Don't want to save that in 1Password. That makes no sense whatsoever. Plug it in, tap it, and now it's saved. Boom, that was super fast. Add another one, add another security key. We'll name this one the YubiKey 5 NFC. Click Next, plug it in. Don't save it in 1Password as a passkey, and tap it and you're good to go. You've got that one. Again, you can add as many as you want here, but one thing to note is when you add these 2FA security keys, you're gonna be required to log in again on your account. So let's say I were to go in and just change something on my Facebook test account here in 1Password. I'm gonna change and use a new password and save that. You can see here that offline changes won't appear until you finish signing in. So you can sign in, and this is where it's gonna ask me to do the authentication. So all you need to do is plug in one of those keys, tap it, and you'll be good to go. And you're gonna see this red cloud with a line through it is gonna disappear in just a moment after that sign in happens. The same thing happens if you sign in on your mobile device. So if I'm opening 1Password on my mobile device, I can open it up and then it is going to ask me to authenticate with my 2FA key. If you've got the NFC key, all you need to do is tap it on the back. If you have the 5CI key, you can just plug it straight into the phone and tap it. Either way, you're authenticating that you are who you say you are when you're logging into this 1Password account, and that's gonna be required for all of the different places where you use or have downloaded 1Password before. Congratulations on leveling up your account security. There are obviously many other accounts where you can use your YubiKey for 2FA security. And if you want to know what all of those are, YubiKey has a list of what works with YubiKey on their website. I'm going to link to that in the description below this video, or you can just use this link, allthingssecure.com/2FA-list, and that will show you everything that works, all of the apps, all of the accounts that work with a YubiKey. Oh, and hold up, before you go, one more thing. If you come up against an account that does not allow for 2FA key security, but it does give you the option for an authenticator app, one of the great features of the YubiKey 5 series is that you can store these authenticator app codes on the key itself. I've done an entire video of how to make use of this. There's the YubiKey Authenticator app for your desktop, for mobile, for tablet, and you just tap or plug in your key to unlock those codes and use them. So if you want that extra security, but 2FA keys are not offered, that's how you would go about doing that. I hope this was super useful for you. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments and I will do my best to respond to them.